My name is Amy Ludwig VanDerwater. I'm happy to be with you here today for Storytime. I'll be reading my book titled That Missing Feeling, and this has been illustrated by Marina Forza and published by Magination Press, which is the children's book imprint of the American Psychological Association. This book is about a feeling we all get sometimes when we miss something. Mia, in this book, misses something. That missing feeling. "Who wants to sprinkle cheese?" Mia's dad called. Mia reached to sprinkle cheddar into a puffy omelet. The kitchen felt warm and smelled delicious. Luna and Toby snuggled. Mia looked up at Grandpa's picture and giggled just like they always giggled together. She could hear her mom singing on her way to the table. This was how mornings used to be, until everything changed. When everything changed, Luna went to live with Mia's mom, and Toby went to live with Mia's dad. Mia lived in both places. She loved her parents, and they loved her. After everything changed, Mia had two of most things: two beds, two favorite mugs, even two toothbrushes. She saw Luna and Toby on different days, so they could no longer snuggle. When she lived at her mom's house, Mia missed her dad's laugh and his cooking. She missed scratching Toby's belly and riding bikes around the block with her dad. She missed racing him to the corner, wind in her hair. When she lived at her dad's house, Mia missed her mom's jokes and her singing. She missed tossing yarn to Luna and raking with her mom. She missed counting 1, 2, 3 and holding hands as they jumped into leaf piles. Mia also missed together times, like the funny time her mom sprayed her dad with the hose. She kept an old picture of her whole family tucked into a corner of her suitcase, and some nights she looked at it and touched everyone's faces. She missed giggling. Mia had that missing feeling a lot. Sometimes that missing feeling made her angry, and she yelled. Sometimes that missing feeling made her sad, and she cried. Sometimes Mia kept that missing feeling all to herself because she did not want to make her parents sad. She knew they loved her very much, and she thought they might feel a little bit sad already. Missing, she knew, is hard. One day when Mia visited Grandpa, he pressed a notebook into her hands. "I never wrote in this, and someone should. It's too good of a notebook to throw away." Mia knew Grandpa did not like to throw things away, and she smiled. Grandpa winked. The notebook was dark blue, and every page was blank. It was perfect for drawing. Mia sat down right that minute and drew her mom and dad spraying each other with the hose. She felt a little bit happy and a little bit sad, and she showed the picture to Grandpa, who looked happy and sad too. Grandpa handed Mia a small notebook. "When we draw and write, we can think about life," he said. "I write memories about Grandma here. She died long before you were born, but I still think about her and write about her." Mia was quiet as she slowly turned the pages. On one page, she saw a photograph of her grandma and grandpa in wedding clothes. On another page, she saw a picture of grandma holding a birthday cake and grandpa with puffed cheeks ready to blow out the candles. On almost every page, she saw words. Lots of words and lots of little drawings here and there. "When I write about grandpa, I'm sad, but I am happy too. She is gone, but you are here. Life changes, and writing helps me think about these changes. My notebook is a home for my heart." "See those? I have filled them all. I remember in my notebooks, honey, and so can you." Mia's grandpa hugged her. She hugged him back, hard. From that day on, Mia wrote or drew in her notebook almost every day. Some days she forgot. Some days she didn't feel like it and talked to Grandpa instead. Always she carried her notebook with her, from her dad's house to her mom's house, and from her mom's house to her dad's house. Whenever Mia got that missing feeling, she drew pictures and wrote words and poems and stories. Sometimes she and Grandpa wrote in their notebooks together. Mia still cried sometimes, but she did not yell anymore. Now, when she lived with her dad, she had fun racing on bikes, and she drew pictures and wrote pages about her mom and Luna. When she lived with her mom, she loved jumping in leaves, and she drew pictures and wrote pages about her dad and Toby. Mia still had two beds, two mugs, and even two toothbrushes. And at times, she still had that missing feeling. But now, Mia had one dark blue notebook. It was a home for her heart. And sometimes, when she wrote and drew, she giggled. The back of this book has a whole lot of ideas for keeping your own notebook. I've kept notebooks for many, many years, and I write about things that make me happy, and I write about things that I miss. I draw, I copy poems in, I make lists, I glue in photographs. Sometimes I even save leaves and tuck them in. So one thing you could do is find an old notebook or find some paper and fold it up and go ahead and just write about anything. It can be words or pictures or a painting or something glued in if you have a little card or a little ticket or a drawing someone gave to you. My parents got divorced, and that's what gave me the idea to write this book. I know that missing feeling. I know lots of people with divorced parents, and just because we're one place or another place doesn't mean that our heart can't be anywhere we wish. My father died this year. This is his sweater. When I wear it, I feel sad, but I feel happy too, because a missing feeling helps us know that there has been something good and we can remember it. So I wish you all kinds of good feelings and all kinds of adventures and memories in your very own notebook. Thank you so much for joining me here for Storytime, and I wish you all the best.